He didn't have a heart, but he still got up. The page predicted all of it. It helped me fight him.
He just disappeared? What the hell is going on here?
We need to figure that out if we're gonna do anything about it. Somehow we need to make sense of this. A dead man turned into a monster. Light as a way to fight him. Pages predicting the future. There's no rational explanation. This is the case we must solve. Keep trying. Think, Saga. There is no rational explanation to what we just saw.
I'd love to blame this on mass hallucination caused by inhaling volcanic gas, but we both know that's bullshit. This was supernatural.
Well, I'm glad you were the one to say it. Now we can figure out a way forward. Right before things got crazy, Sheriff Breaker just vanished.
Maybe the sheriff knew more than he was letting on.
He seemed anxious. Like he dreaded what was coming. One more mystery. The victim of a ritualistic murder turns into a monster. Is there a connection?
Looks to me like the cult of the tree is performing rituals to create monsters.
Maybe. We need to start with learning this cult's goal, their purpose.
The killers are usually the ones performing the ritual, not the detective. Acting out their sick fantasy. They may be trying to get you involved, forcing you into their twisted world.
The autopsy room was a mess, like a bomb had gone off. Nightingale hunted Saga, didn't see her under the light, lurched past her. The Taken could not see into bright light. The light hurt them, hurt the darkness in them, made them vulnerable. I flick the switch, it goes click, Show me the clicker. Lights are off, but somebody's home. Hemingway brought you here, witch. Get out of my house, Nightingale shouted. A wave of terror crashed through Saga's head. The awful truth. Nightingale had no heart in his chest, but here he was, killing a monster. The world had lurched out of balance. You found yourself trapped on the far side of the mirror.
Did the fucker take it with him?
Saga was back at Cauldron Lake. Saga had to pursue Nightingale into the overlap. Finding a way in would be difficult. A ritual. Saga would learn how. Stop the monster. Saga was back at Cauldron Lake. He was there too. Nightingale. Was, but wasn't a Taken, a creature of darkness. He was beyond her reach, where some other strange reality, the Dark Place, merged with ours. This place and the Dark Place, a tarp thrown over top, drowning everything beneath it, a flood of darkness, soaking into everything, spoiling it, rotting it. The page called this area an overlap. Saga had to pursue Nightingale into the overlap. Finding a way in would be difficult, required precise steps, a ritual. Saga would learn how. Stop the monster before he killed again. Her job, he'd be inside. Waiting for her.
Can't be opened on this side. It won't open. The page places Nightingale back at Cauldron Lake. Calls him a Taken. We need to head over there, stop him, before anyone else gets hurt.
Okay.
We heard gunshots. Y'all okay?
Did you get spooked by the bodies?
Sheriff Breaker disappeared. Nightingale turned into some sort of a monster, and there are offices down. You two handle things here. We need to get back to Cauldron Lake immediately.
Fuck me. That's terrible. We'll do what we can, man.
But that's crazy, right, Thornton? Nightingale's heart was missing. How could he do anything? He's dead.
Yeah, right. Well, that's all crazy talk. Monsters aren't real, and what do you mean the sheriff disappeared? He's gone like magic? Magic's not real.
Magic's not real. Right, Mulligan?
No, Thornton. Monsters aren't real, and magic's definitely not real.
I knew that.
I need something to cut this.
Fine pair.
dear. I am a tourist, and it appears that I'm lost in the woods. You only had a tour guide, also. It's bear season. Oh no, a bear. Help. Did somebody call for a tour guide? Oh, wow. Koskala Brothers Adventure Tours. Unforgettable tour experiences at affordable prices. That's right. I'm Ilmo Koskala, voted best coffee roaster / tour guide by Coffee World Magazine. And I'm here to give you a tour of a lifetime. But Ilmo, I've heard the government has seized and restricted access to many local nature attractions. That is true, Yanko. Many local attractions have recently become fenced off by the government. And that's why at Koskala Brothers Adventure Tours, we say, fuck the government. We have bolt cutters. Oh, wow. You think of everything. And we'll take you anywhere. Hiking through the scenic Elderwood National Park. Fishing in the crystal clear waters of Bright Falls Dam. Bird watching at majestic Mirror Peak. The tour of a lifetime is just one phone call away. Book now to get a 9% discount on this limited edition Old Beer Diner
Coaster. Long enough. Are you gonna let me speak to them or not?
Just a moment, ma'am. Someone will be right with you.
How many times do we have to do this, Walter? Huh? I'm at my wit's end with you. Do you think I like throwing you in jail every other day? No, I don't. Do you have any idea how much paperwork you're causing me? What's a lot?
I want out! Something bad's going down. I can feel it. Let me out!
Sit here and stew for a while. Think about your life choices, buddy. Is it really worth this?
It doesn't budge. Nightingale and his cult are dangerous. We need to be prepared in case things escalate more than they already have. Can you call it in, Casey?
A smart choice, Anderson. Yeah, Agent Casey here. Yeah. We need backup. The Bright Falls case. Whoever you can spare. ASAP. Think we'll actually find Nightingale at the lake?
The pages haven't been wrong yet.
We can't assume the person writing these pages isn't playing us.
I agree. But it's our best lead.
Mercetta won't roll over on the issues.
I'm gonna take a quick look around. Meet you back at the car.
See you in a bit.
That concludes our debate on whether pets should be allowed at this year's bake sale. For those of you just tuning in, you're listening to the Pat Main Radio Hour, brought to you by Davis Family Moose Jerky. And boy, what an eventful day here in Bright Falls. By now, we've all seen the FBI setting up shop in town, and I'm sure you're all asking the same question.
Did you check out the town, Anderson?
Just getting my bearings. Ready to go?
Waiting on you.
Rinse and repeat. Clock out, get a beer. Or maybe three.
I need to come clean, Anderson. I know why Nightingale was here 13 years ago. He was chasing a writer. Alan Wake.
Tammy mentioned him. She's writing a book on his disappearance.
You know the detective character from his books, Alex Casey.
Yeah, I've heard the jokes at the office. Cold Case Casey. Murder Case Casey. Sorry.
Ha ha. It's the same name, similar job. It's the first thing anyone thinks of. It annoyed me, but that was it. Then, 10 years ago, I started getting strange letters in the mail. Fragments of prose describing murders. You've heard the stories about what happened in New York, some of it at least. Bodies started to pile up. It was a murder cult. Turns out the fragments sent to me were from the crime books of Alan Wake. The cult was copycatting the murders from the books. In their heads, they were performing a ritual to bring Wake back. Their imagined prophet. After that case, I started looking into Wake's disappearance on the side.
And you thought this case might be connected to him? His name does keep popping up.
I just wanted you to have all the facts.
Next time, give them to me before we find ourselves in the middle of a horror story. The page says Nightingale's in something called an overlap. Need to figure out exactly what that means.
I'm happy I'm not in charge of this mess.
Thanks. Let's start looking for Nightingale where he was killed. The writer of these pages knows what will happen. Because they're behind this, or because they can see what's coming. Impossible things are happening here. A world operating on different rules. I need to understand this strange logic. To see the clues. To solve the case. I've been thinking more about the cult of the tree. What sort of cult refers to themselves as a cult?
In my experience, they don't.
We're not seeing the full picture yet.
Hey, hello there. How are you folks doing?
Those restricted area signs don't do a damn thing.
Hello. Saga Anderson. Are you two supposed to be here?
I'm Ilmo Koskela. Fantastic to meet you. And yes, Stephen here hired me to show him through the woods. He's in town on important government business. Fixing this impressive piece of hardware.
I work for the FBC, ma'am. I'm authorized to be here.
And I bet you two are here about that murder. Nasty stuff. How's it going?
How did you hear about the murder, Ilmo? Do you know anything that could help us?
People tend to tell me things. The Koskela brothers are kind of a household name around here. Speaking of, if you're looking for some fun, stop by Watery. Just down the road from Bright Falls, there's our Coffee World amusement park. There's Sauna da Vista. And we offer a variety of guided tours, hunting, fishing, hiking, whatever strikes your fancy. You name it, we probably got it.
What is this thing?
It's just a monitoring station, ma'am. The Federal Bureau of Control checks volcanic activity and air toxicity levels. No need to worry, though. It's mostly for research purposes.
That's one gorgeous weather saga. Looks Nordic. I bet a family member made it.
My mother made this sweater for me. How do you know?
I knew it. My mom used to knit those sweaters for me and my brother. Watery, my hometown, was founded by Finnish immigrants. So between your name and the sweater, I figured your family might be from Finland too. Suomi, Finland. Pulla, Karjalan piirakka.
Close. My mom's family is from Sweden originally. I don't know much about them beyond that. The sweater is just something to remember her by. Stephen, we're investigating a murder that occurred nearby. What can you tell me about your bureau?
Nothing that isn't classified, I'm afraid. But I don't know anything about a murder. Operations here are run by a different department. I'm just here to make some repairs. The wiring on this thing frays every couple months.
Yep, that's the raccoons. They grow real big here with teeth like you wouldn't believe. Can't gnaw right through a garbage can.
Well, I need to get back to it.
What the hell is this?
Let's get to the murder site, Casey.
Nothing. Just something that shouldn't be here.
A lot of things about this case keep bothering me. But one thing feels really off. Breaker's disappearance. I don't get the feeling Nightingale was responsible.
He was about to give you more of those pages. Something didn't want us to have them? Or was protecting him from Nightingale? Spontaneous combustion? I don't know. Not the kind of disappearance we normally solve. Our crime scene's drowning. I never minded the rain. Feels like home.
No sign of Nightingale. But the page did place him at Cauldron Lake, in an overlap. So how do we follow him there?
Maybe something around here will tell us.
We've seen this symbol before.
Hmm. Good eye.
Bare feet. Nightingale. I'll see where these footprints lead. Can you comb through the crime scene one more time, KC? Just in case?
On it. If anything comes up, I'll radio you.
The tracks lead into the water. Where'd you go from here? I can feel something. A presence. Nightingale isn't far. These aren't the same tracks that were here before. They're headed into the tree, not out of it. What is that? I know Nightingale is somewhere around Cauldron Lake.
The tree was a threshold. This place and the dark place. You're in over your head. Next stop, Caldera Street Station.
The threshold, like a doorway, leading to Nightingale. It's somehow connected to a tree, which is Ladle?
My flashlight burned the dark stuff away.
The fuse was in place. Saga stepped into the witch's hut. Inside, a bright light. There were objects that stood out to Saga, as if the light had manifested them.
The witch's hut. Okay. I trust the pages to lead me to the overlap.
The fuse was in place. She found it among the junk in the forest. Saga stepped inside the witch's hut. Something rushed through her. A presence. Familiar. She couldn't quite place it. Something long forgotten. She tried to hold on to it, but it was already gone. Inside, a bright light. Saga felt safe. Like nothing could hurt her here. There were objects that stood out to Saga as if the light had manifested them. Pulled them from the darkness. A shift in reality, heavy with hidden meanings. A coffee thermos, a shoebox, a mop and a bucket, a poster on the wall, and in the cabinet, another manuscript page.
Is Witch's Ladle the doorway into the overlap? If so, that's where I'll find Nightingale. Light is the key. To stay safe. But for something more to be revealed as well. I need to find the witch's hut. This is the witch's hut.
Anderson, thought I saw something in the woods. Probably just a deer, but I'm gonna check it out.
Okay. I found another page. Following up on a lead. Keep checking in.
Roger.
This fuse is busted. This one looks good. People should really stop littering, though. A lunchbox again. Who's leaving these out here? Another page. Making progress.
The image of the witch in the sign. Saga addressed the witch. The smudged line on the heart. The second part recited from memory. I brought you the heart, witch. Show me the terror. Saga pushed the heart through the hole in the sign. Witch's ladle. Towering over Saga. Watching her and the witch. The image of the witch in the sign. Nightingale's heart, a cold, dead lump in her hand. Her definition of sanity had changed since she arrived in this town. But she trusted the pages. Was forced to. Saga addressed the witch. She squinted to read the first part of the ritual words. The smudged line on the heart. The second part recited from memory. The words she had read on the page. I brought you the heart, witch. Show me the terror. Saga pushed the heart through the hole in the sign. This was the key. The tree was the threshold.
The page from the witch's hut seems to be describing some kind of ritual. Think, Saga. To get into the overlap, I need to find Nightingale's heart. Read the line imprinted on it, plus the line on the page to the witch's ladle sign. Then push the heart through the hole in the sign. Nightingale's heart disappeared from the morgue. Where is it now?
I need Nightingale's heart to get to the overlap. Where is it?
The cultist leaned close. He was there, but he was risen. Nightingale was there. The opposite of sunspots. Who said that?
That's not it. I don't have what I need to find Nightingale's heart. There must be more. Nightingale's heart. Where is it?
Meanwhile, they played cards in the general store. The witch had stolen his heart. Get out of my house.
Nightingale's heart is at the general store, in a fridge. I need to check the general store for the heart. Casey, I'm headed to the general store. I think I know how to get into the overlap.
Roger that. I followed some ATV tracks in the woods and got a bit turned around.
Did you get lost?
I've only been lost once in my life, Anderson. The years I spent with my ex-wife. I'll find my way back, don't you worry about it.
Meanwhile, they played cards in the general store. The witch had stolen his heart. Get out of my house.
I have to head back. Got things to do.
Ugh.
The text on the heart is clearer now. Legible. Sounds literary, but what does it mean? I feel like I recognize this. The fridge. The heart. I knew it would be here. Like I saw it in a dream. And now I need to give the heart to the witch. Makes total sense. Casey, there are cultists in the area. They're taken, like Nightingale. Watch yourself out there.
Yeah, thanks for the heads up. I'm still finding my way back.
You have the worst sense of direction.
Any city in America I can get through drunk and blindfolded. It's these damn trees.
Okay. I'm en route to Witch's Ladle. I need to perform a ritual to open the overlap. This case just keeps getting weirder.
But it is exciting. Found the heart in the fridge, just like the page said I would.
Witch's ladle, towering over Saga, watching her and the witch. The image of the witch in the sign, Nightingale's heart, a cold, dead lump in her hand. Her definition of sanity had changed since she arrived in this town. But she trusted the pages, was forced to. Saga addressed the witch. She squinted to read the first part of the ritual words, the smudged line on the heart. The second part recited from memory, the words she had read on the page. I brought you the heart, witch. Show me the terror. Saga pushed the heart through the hole in the sign. This was the key. The tree was the threshold.
Good job, Saga. Now keep moving.
wave crashed on the far side of the mirror. I brought you the Heart Witch. Show me the terror. On your way? Casey! Casey, do you read me? Fuck. Okay, Saga. Going in solo.
Mom.
Logan?
Mom, help!
Logan! Where are you? Logan's back in Virginia. You're imagining things. What was that? Wait. Did I get turned around? No, this is right. This place is looping. Like a nightmare. Need to find Nightingale. He's here. Nightingale. It's like they're coming in over a bad signal. Nightingale's badge. I'm Saga Anderson, FBI. I can hear you.
Cauldron Lake.
Yes. I'm at Cauldron Lake. Where are you?
I'm not going to escape. In danger. The dark presence.
Danger. Thanks. Got it. Are you okay?
No! It's my fault! They got out with my face scratched!
Sir, calm down. I'm gonna need you to take a breath.
He's changed the story. The dark presence. We must stop it before...
Easy now. First things first. What's your name?
My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer. I've been...
Wake? Where did you come from? You've been missing for 13 years.
13.
And I don't need to hide. My foolish pride paid the price. I will never leave again. I'm by your side. I was calling you. Did you hear me? I lost my way. Lost my way.